Hello, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whatever it is where you are, and welcome back to another episode on the Annoy Dad YouTube channel. In today's episode, we are going to try to prove a myth. A myth that says that apparently, if you try really, really hard, you can hatch eggs that are brought from the supermarket. I've heard this from a number of people over a number of times, and I've always thought it is the biggest load of balearics going. I have never heard such rubbish. The reason being, because every time you see them on the TV, you see the chickens running around and there's lots and lots of hens. You don't ever see the cockerels. So how are they going to hatch if there's no cockerels with them? But then I got talking to some people, and there were some people who told me that if you get the free range ones, apparently from a certain few farms, they actually keep some cockerels in with them. If it's the caged hens or the barn reared hens, you don't get that. So, I was up at my local Sainsbury's, as you can see I've got the receipt just here, and I was buying some for our Can You Hatch Quail Eggs from the supermarket video. And whilst I was there, I decided that I would buy some other eggs as well, because it had been years since I've actually stopped in any supermarket and looked to see what eggs they sell. Reason being, I don't need to because I got my own eggs coming in. So, I decided to buy some eggs. That stands for Taste the Difference eggs, which is these ones at the back here, times 6, £1.85 for 6. My god, I need to raise my prices. I only charge £1 for 6, and mine come straight off the farm. Taste the Difference blue, which are these ones down here, times 6, £1.85. Two lots of quail eggs for £2.75, and Clarence Court duck eggs, these ones at the back here, for £2.55. I know I said no more ducks, but you know, I've got to give it a go just to see. So what we've got is just basically free range eggs which have come straight off the shelf at the supermarket. If I show you with these ones, you can see that they are the supermarket ones because they're printed. Now for those of us, they've also got the best before date on them at the 4th of February. Today at the time of recording this, it is the 13th of January. So for those of you in the USA, you may be wondering why you never see English eggs on the shelf in the USA. It's because our eggs aren't washed. These ones come straight from the hen's bum, and they normally fall out of the nest box onto a conveyor. Along the conveyor, they get scanned, they get printed, and they get packed. And that is it, straight away. Whereas in the USA, they tend to wash the eggs first, which isn't allowed over here because of, I don't know, European laws or something ridiculous like that. So anyway, these eggs, you can see even these ones, they're printed, but they're meant to be free range ones. So it is gonna be really interesting to see, can we get anything at all from these? These eggs are gonna go straight into an incubator we used last year, which is a really, really good one. It is the Arcom King Sorrow 20. It's a bit of an older incubator, but it's quite a good incubator, and it does quite well for our purposes. So what we're going to do is we're going to load them all in, then we're going to come back in a week's time, and we're going to candle them, and we are going to see, can you actually hatch supermarket eggs? I don't think you can. I'm going to place my bets there. I'll tell you what, pause the video now, scroll down, and then leave us a comment. Do you think it will work? I don't know. So this has been turned on already. You can see you can't because I angled you down. There we go. See, it's been turned on. The temperature's up in it nicely. Reason why we do that is we like to turn it on, one, to check it's working, and two, by turning it on, it's like warming up your oven, so it gets the heat in everywhere. Because in these, like you see just off the side of the screen there, you see there's like air gaps underneath and other bits and pieces. So if you turn it on for a few hours, leave it on, it gets a chance for everything to warm up, which is what you want basically. Right, so let's start off with the duck eggs. Now I did take a quick peek at these packs when I brought them back yesterday. So these are the duck eggs, Braddock Whites from Clarence Court. And I got no idea what a Braddock White is, but I was looking at them and that one's okay, that can go in. That one, no, I'm not sure if the camera can pick it up. You can see at the top there where the air sac is on it. I must admit, I really do hope that these don't hatch, because I really don't want any more ducks. So that one there, that can go in. So as I said, these were just picked up off the shelf at Sainsbury's. I was fairly sure that there were two, where I'd had a quick look at them, that were cracked. Like that one there is, you can see it just in there. Plus that's an oversized one as well, so that wouldn't go in anyway. But I was fairly sure. Yes, I was right. Just in the top bit there. Like obviously the easiest way of doing it was if I got out the candling light and I could candle it and then you'd be able to see it. But just in the top there, all the shower's cracked. So that one there's taken out. But the candling light is still packed away for the winter and I haven't unpacked it yet. So so that's those four in. So we're going to have four duck eggs. Then let's go for the free range eggs. So these are just normal hen's eggs. There's absolutely nothing special about them. I'll explain something in just a second about the packet on them. I thought it was quite amusing. But that one I just put in, that's a bit of an odd shaped one. That one, if there is anything in there, I don't think it will do anything. But hey, it will be interesting to see. So, yeah, as I was saying about these ones, these are Sainsbury's Taste the Difference 6 free-range golden yolked British eggs. Now, as anybody who's anybody knows, yes, there is a taste difference between the eggs I produce and the eggs you buy at the standard ordinary supermarket ones. But the yolks, that comes down to what the birds are fed. You can increase the colour of the yolk just by adding stuff to their feed. So if you want to get like a really, really rich yellow, you can just add stuff to the feed. It's not a hard thing to do. But anyway, that's them. So we'll move on to the free range British blues. And these are some odd shaped eggs. I presume these are going to be like a leg bar type thing, if there is any chance of them hatching at all. One good thing of them being printed is that it will show if any of them have been removed and if I've done anything with them. I don't think I'm going to be able to get them all in, but that is a bit of a torpedo one. That's not exactly a egg shaped one, so I'll leave that one to one side. I'll show you the box on these ones again. 6 Taste the Difference British Blue. But it doesn't say the breed of bird. I suspect it to be some sort of leg bar or something. But there you go. And then finally, I'm fitting in. This is from one of our other videos where we have done the... We are doing, as I speak, the hatching quail eggs. Okay, so that is it. That is our incubator, fully loaded up with plenty of eggs in there. So, like I say, leave us a comment down below. Do you think any will hatch? And we will jump back to this video in 1 week's time. Well, it'll be a week for me. It'll just be a couple of seconds for you. And we will see. We will candle them. Will any of them be fertile? I don't know. I don't hold out much hope, but I really, really hope that some of them are. Let's see. Okay, so here we go. We are on the 7-day mark. Normally I would leave these sort of things until day 10 before I candle them. Normally you would candle at day 10, then at day 18, and then they should hatch what is remaining, as long as nothing nasty happens to them. But because we have just candled the quail eggs, I decided that we're going to do these ones now. You'll be able to see now if anything is actually growing in them, if anything is happening. So what we've got is we've got our nice candlelight here. Oh, I just mentioned the quail eggs. If you haven't done so already, go and have a look at the quail egg video where we tried to hatch the supermarket quail eggs, and have a look and see how well we failed with that, because it was absolute total failure. I've got no idea how these are going to go yet, but I've got the candler, I've got the eggs, I'm going to hit the lights and we'll find out. Okay, here goes. If it glows like a light bulb, there's nothing in there. Okay, unfortunately that one there is. That one's got, excuse my French, I'm not gonna speak French, but that one, I don't know if you can see it or not, but I can see veins in there. Holy mackerel, Batman. Let's have a look at this next one. Ah, you see that one there? That looks different. That's just totally empty. That's glowing like a light bulb, that one there is. As is that one there. Look, you can see the veins. Can you see the veins? See where the lion is? And then there's these red lines. It doesn't come out very well on the camera, but it certainly does come out well with me looking at them. My God, I am shocked. I shouldn't be shocked, but... yeah, and that one there's empty. My God. Wow. Okay, we're moving on to the brown ones. These are the ones with the... yolks, their claim of the golden yolks, but we all know the truth in that, really, don't we? So yeah, I apologize if the camera does go blurry, it's just one of those things. There we go, let it focus in. So you can see all of these are just glowing. I say they glow like light bulbs when they're empty, because they do, and the whole thing, like, if I turn it round, you can see there's a dark patch there, that's where the yolk is. So if I turn it round so as the yolk is on the other side of the egg, you can see how it's all clear. And then if I lay it down, it's not an air sac big enough in that one. Let's try another one. This is the last of the chicken eggs. Yeah, these don't seem to have really big air sacs, so I can't show you the air sac. There's me yabbering about it. Right, onto the duck. There were four duck eggs and I was hoping and praying that there's nothing in these ones. Whoa, my God, that's bright. So as you can see, that one there's empty. But you can see this bit around the top here. This is the air sac. I put it over on its side like that. You can see. Let's move it round and down. So you can see there quite clearly, the yolk has now floated up to the top. There's the air sac on the side there, so that bit in there, that's just air. And the rest of that is all of the egg white. So there you go. Who would have thought you'd watch one of my videos and you might actually learn something? And that one there's also empty. The duck eggs at this time of year, yeah, I do expect them to be empty. My freaking fork! Look at that! Jeepers! Jeepers creepers, I was not expecting that, I must admit. Okay, so there we go. Wowzers, right, let me hit the lights. Whew. Dear, there we go. Okay, so we are left. I can't believe this. We got one duck in there and we've got two chicken. I'm going to lay them like that because then they got the lines on them, and then I can't be accused of them. Oh, you take them for other eggs. No, they were actually supermarket bought ones, and they're fertile, three of them. Wowzers. Right, I am going to get them covered back up. I am going to put them back in the cradle, and we will come back to them on day 15 for the chicken eggs, because we'll put them into lockdown, and I use the other incubator to put them into lockdown on, and then we can leave the duck one in here, but we can check the duck one as well to see if that's also fertile. And yeah, we will go from there. So yeah, the next bit is going to be in 8 days time from now, but it'll obviously just be in a couple of seconds for you guys, and you'll be able to see if we can hatch the supermarket eggs. Oh my god.